thought you'd be 10 yards tall the way Zevlor spoke of you. Ceres, Scout. Seems we missed one another at the Grove, but the others told me how you helped us. A pity. You pulled them from one death trap, only for me to land them in this one. Aye. Not a battle she's likely to put to song. Maybe we should have just surrendered. Zevlor begged us to. But they were toying with us. Making examples. And we'd had enough of taking it. Those of us who cut free just kept running till we found this place. The others... Maybe the cult got them. Maybe the curse. Zevlor had hope. It didn't save him. A little sense will serve us better, I think. But... thanks. It was sweet of you to try.
You're all right, thank goodness. I was worried they'd got you too. Honestly, terribly, I still can't believe it. The cultists, the screams. Roland, of all people, saved us. He said he stayed in the Grove because of you. I'm damn glad of it. Without him, well, none of us would be here. Yes. He shielded me and the kids, while his brother and sister rushed the cultists. Cal and Leah were dragged away, along with the others. Roland isn't taking it so well. None of us are, to be honest. How do you do it? How do you keep going? You're made of sterner stuff than me, then. You've done so much for us already. But I have to ask. The others might still be out there. If they're not dead, they're in Moonrise. And gods have mercy on anyone in that hell's pit. Thank you. If anyone can manage it, you can. Just be careful up there, all right? I can't handle anyone else dying.
Please. Be welcome. Have a drink.
Oh, my gods!
To your very good health.
You perceive a faint hint of cloth grass, a herb that is said to elicit the truth. Jahira smiles at you knowingly.
It doesn't spoil the taste, if that's what you're wondering. Indulge me. You don't know what you're missing. Well over a century old, and yet it hasn't lost a hint of flavor. Still not quite so sure about you, though. People tend to lose more than just flavor when illithids get their hands on them. I speak from experience. There's an air about you. Something alien. Answer me true and do not lie. The parasite is changing you, isn't it? Look around you. Good men, good women. Stranded here, 2 feet in the grave. If we're to survive, I have no choice but to trust you. Can I?
Good.
Because I'll cross your heart myself if you break it.
I have every reason to be cautious.
I've traced people like you. People with parasites in their brains. All the way here from Baldur's Gate.
The cult of the Absolute is spreading through the city. Quietly, quickly, and with unsettling deliberation. We tracked them to this ancient village, only to be faced with a man we killed and buried over a century ago.
General Gadrick Thorm. Remember that name. He's the leader of the Absolutists.
He was a Sharan once. Took to building an army of Dark Justiciars beneath this very village. Alongside the local druids, we made it our business to see him deposed, dead and buried. But he's returned. Not only does General Gadrick Thorm live again, it seems he is no longer mortal. He has become, in fact, invincible. We met him on the road here, commanding an army of the Absolute, intent on destroying Baldur's Gate. I put an arrow through his eye myself, only to watch him pluck it out like a splinter. He healed, right in front of me, and chased us into the shadows. Things looked hopeless. But experience has taught me that no matter how bleak things look, there's always hope. You are that hope. Protected by your artifact, you can infiltrate his forces at Moonrise Towers, posing as a true soul. Find out what it is that makes him invincible, so we can strip him of his advantage.
Once Gadrick is without his shield, the sword, together we assault his tower and put a final end to this blight.
Without a cure for your infection, your days are numbered too. Yet you selflessly offer to spend them fighting alongside us. I like you. I promise I will do everything I can to make sure you survive this. Any cure starts with understanding the disease. Whatever magic Gadrick's using to control these tadpoles, it must be at Moonrise.
Until then, we keep drinking wine when we meet.
You're not our only secret weapon. Isobel, a faithful cleric of Siluna, and a light in the darkness. She cast the moon shield around the inn. It's the only reason we're still alive.
She's upstairs, in her chambers. Tell her I sent you, and she'll see you through the shadows safely. Isobel's in her room upstairs. She'll be expecting you.
Premium trinkets and doodahs!
The colors are faded, but the words are not. An ale between friends is worth 10 cups of tea.
Any treasure?
Can't say I have.
Last light.
If I do, you'll be the first to know.
Promise?
I promise, kid.
Good to see you're still breathing. It's the best we can hope for.
Don't waste a step.
If I wanted water, I would bloody ask for it.
More for me?
Okay.
Your job is to serve drinks, you little devil. Do it!
Please!
Shouting!
I'm not shout-
There's another bottle of Arabellan Dry back there. Put it on the bar, then piss off and leave me alone.
Jahira said we should serve drinks, but that we shouldn't serve drunks.
Jahira didn't save your ragged little tail from the cultists. I did.
Ah, it's you. Don't you get tired of telling people how to live their lives?
If you're here to save the day again, you're a little late this time. I tried.
Maybe she'll write a ballad about me.
She can leave out the part where my brother and sister were dragged away screaming while I was saving the orphans. If you hadn't filled their heads with all that self-righteous heroic crap at the Grove, none of this would have happened. They're my responsibility. You go save the world, or your own arse, or whatever it is you do. I'll fix this.
I tried telling Mr. Roland that he'd had enough too. He didn't like it then either.
Flight's best bargains right here!
Children from El Dorel. Maybe not, Mom.
mug of ale, 4 CP, chopped cheek, 3 SP, daily special in choir.
Better not be cursed.
Premium trinkets and doodahs!
A bust of Catherick Thorm as he once was, a devotee of Saluna.
Well met.
As I listen.
I didn't realize I had an audience. The true soul who's going to save us all. I'm Isabel. Pleased to meet you.
Myself and our lady are doing what we can to hold the line. I hear you and your tadpole will be our offense. Free from the Absolute's influence, yet able to walk among cultists. It's almost too good to be true. But I'd be a poor cleric indeed not to avail of a blessing when I see one. Let me guess. Jahira sent you to beg a protection spell off her favorite cleric.
It hurts.
Perfect. It'll make you immune to the lesser effects of the Shadow Curse, which will get you closer to the towers. But there are places it won't help. Places where the curse is darker, stronger. The cultists are able to traverse even the deepest shadows, though. I don't know how. The Harpers are trying to figure it out.
Saloonite magic. Dark Lady, forgive me.
Good nose. Like a nasty little terrier. Ketherick is a frightening man, but you have something he doesn't. Allies worth having. While you're busy in the towers, I'll be sure to... Wait. Do you hear that? Something's wrong.
Hello, Isabel.
Marcus, is that you? What's happened to you?
I've been blessed. You can be too. Come with me, and you can hear all about it from Ketherick himself.
He's a flaming fist. Or was. Came with the others when we created this haven.
And I thank you for your hospitality. True soul, my instructions are clear. Take the girl to Ketherick, alive.
A haunting face swims into your mind's eye, its instructions vivid in your mind. Nothing is more important than bringing the girl alive.
What's going on? If you have something to say, say it.
Pathetic. The Absolute sees all. Your treachery will be punished.
The Absolute. Of course. You can't believe them, Marcus. Ketherick will never give you whatever it is you've been promised.
He already has. Time to go, Isabel.
Moon Maiden, guide.
You'll make excellent fertilizer.
On my feet.
Isabel! No! What in the nine hells happened? God spare us! Catherick was planning our demise all along. Listen closely, for there's very little time. Even if last light falls, your mission does not change. You must find Catherick Thorm, and you must kill him. As impossible as that task sounds, there must be a way to break the spell that makes him invincible. There are secrets in this ancient waste, hidden from... But hark, something stirs. It's happening. They'll all be taken by the shadows. Only by the grace of Isabel's spell will we be spared the same fate. We cannot hesitate. Not even for those we knew. Those we cared for. They're no longer who they were. Still your hearts, and steady your hands. To battle!
Thank you.
in my way. Close ranks.
Is the fearless. Finding my way.
Poor fucker. Incoming.
come through.
My turn. Don't waste a step. Swift as my feet can carry me. It's all over.
They're all gone. My brave ones, my friends, my harpers. I led them here. To this. After such carnage, you'd persist? Sometimes there's folly in such courage. Perhaps it's right that you're not. You're twice blessed, after all. By Isabel and by your artifact. But as for myself, I don't see another option than to make a desperate dash back to Baldur's Gate. Chances are slim I'd survive the journey back. But if I can warn the Dukes an army of absolutists is on the march, perhaps the city still stands a fighting chance. That proud determination of yours should shame me. But it heartens me instead. Pull aside the curtain of years and I can see myself echoing your resolve. Very well. I'll join you. And when Ketherick falls, I'll be there. For us, for them, and for the ones we love back home.
What's in here? Be on my way. Something's on my mind.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? Let me see if it will answer my summons a second time.
Ah, Blurg. Are you in need of my expertise? I greet you, Sun Child. May your travels be safe and swift.
Welcome back. I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well. Have you spoken with Skriss lately?
Yes. She is cataloging coital and fertility rituals.
Welcome back. I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well. Thank you.
I suppose this place is no worse for wear than my last lodgings. Though I cannot say the same for myself, I fear. The battle, the escape after. I might need to lick my wounds a while before I can be of use to you. I need a little time. But I will gladly join you at Journey's End. So long as it leads to the grave of General Getherick Thorne. The time for words will come when we lay my harpers to their final rest. I owe them that. But first, I owe them justice. Moonrise must fall. You know your task. Getherick Thorne clawed his way free of death. Find out how, so we can send him back.
Hey, soldier.
Something good here, I hope.
You wish to speak?
Poor soul. But in truth, if I had to choose between death and the Shadowfell, I'd choose death. Perhaps there's still a way to learn something from him. The dead can't deny their knowledge if asked the right question.
He is? Then I must see him. Insensible or not, he knows something. I will go to see him at once. Join me when you can.
Wish I had a bag of holding. What's hiding here? Thank you.
with haste. Anything of use?
I'd love to, thanks. Open up.
Whatever it takes.
Can't give up now. No traps, please. On my way.
Always room for more. Come on, open up.
Leah, Cal, if you see this, stay put. I will return in a 10-day at most. I repeat, stay put.
We'll need help to survive those shadows. Only a fool would face them alone.
The corpse regards you lifelessly.
Curse. Darkness. Pain. Senyo. Have to help. Senyo. Shadowfell. Yes.
Soul's power wanes, you can ask no more questions.
Open up. Cursed to put my hands on everything. Not bad. I've had better days. And worse ones.